So today we are going to study experiment number 2, basic chemistry laboratory techniques, in which we are going to study burner. So see this, is a Bunsen burner. It consists of metal tube with bore at the base. This bore is surrounded by metal collar, by using which the bore can be opened or closed. See this. When we close that bore, the oxygen supply will get reduced and we get a sooty flame, which is yellow in color. This luminous flame, it acts as a reducing agent, and this flame we use for a charcoal test. This flame does not provide much of heat. For regular practicals, we are using blue flame, that is in presence of oxygen. So see this blue flame. For adjusting the flame, we are using that bore which is present at the base of Bunsen burner. So in this Bunsen burner, there are two zones, inner zone and outer zone. The darker side represents darker blue color of the flame represents inner zone, and light blue color flame indicates outer zone. Okay, outer zone is the hottest zone, and while inner zone, that will be the coldest zone in this Bunsen burner. So today we will see operating of pinch cock or stop cock. In last video we have seen how to use a burette. In that I have explained you already how to use a pinch cock. So the rubber tube is closed by a pinch cock. You can see that a glass tube is attached to the rubber tube, and which is attached to the pinch cock. By pressing the pinch cock with one hand, you can add the solution drop wise to the conical flask. While titrating, you have to add the solution from burette to the conical flask by pressing that pinch cock. So you have to operate that pinch cock from one hand. When you release that pinch cock, the solution will stop, and when you press that pinch cock, the solution will get added drop wise. So in one hand you will have a conical flask, and you have to operate the pinch cock with only one hand. Now we will see handling of concentrated acid containers. So these are the concentrated acids which we always keep in a glass bottles, which are placed in a vessel or tray containing dry sand. These acids are extremely corrosive to all body tissues and very dangerous for eyes and skin. But if we handle it carefully, then you need not be feared. So whenever you are using concentrated acid, you have to use a test tube holder. Whenever you are dealing with concentrated acid, use dropper. Never pipette out any concentrated acid by mouth using pipette. So remember this, don't use pipette for dealing with concentrated acid. You have to use a glass dropper when you are dealing with concentrated acids, and test tube holder is a must. If suppose a small amount of acid, it falls on your skin, first wipe out that acid part with the cloth or napkin or filter paper, and then wash your skin under tap water. Don't wash immediately with water. It will react with water and you will get a burn mark on your skin. So first remove that amount of acid by filter paper or napkin or cloth, and then you are going to wash your that skin part under tap water. So there will be a little amount of hurt to the skin. If your skin gets injured by the concentrated acid, then do the dressing and use a first aid box to deal with it. And do not throw any concentrated acids directly to the basin. You have to add water into the concentrated acid and then only you have to pour that acid part into the basin, or it will directly react with the stainless steel part and it will get corrode. Okay, so remember this. So this was our experiment number 2, basic laboratory techniques. Thank you.